The key to riding an avalanche train is preparation. I'm going to show you how throughout this virtual training series. These are proven effective techniques. I'll be sharing my 24 years of instructing experience in short segments that get right to the point. Today, we're Jeremy Mercier, brand ambassador for Ski-Doo, and we're in his garage. Jeremy, how's it going today?
Good, welcome to my garage.
Thanks.
It's fun to get to be able to do this together.
It is. Is that the sled you rode last year?
It is the sled I rode last year. I got it in January and put about 1,800 miles on it, and it's just been a great sled.
Well, I follow you online. You're always finding the powder. Do you have any secrets on how you find the powder?
For sure, Mike. It's kind of a full-time job. I get up super early in the morning and I'll look at all the snowtell sites.
Oh, okay.
And you can see these anywhere from Wyoming, Oregon, Washington.
Sure.
They're available to the public, and I'll usually get on there and see how much snow had fallen overnight. Mm-hmm. And usually go to that area. But it doesn't snow every week, right, in Colorado. So a lot of times it's using Google Earth and tools like that, and just going out and researching new areas.
Do you share your secret stashes?
I do not share my secret stashes. I feel like you need to earn them. And another big one is just for a safety reason. A lot of the areas I ride are pretty high avalanche danger mm-hmm. areas, and you need to be really educated to ride these zones.
Sure. What's your avalanche training level?
I have a level 2 from Silverton Avalanche School, and yours truly. And I've been taking avalanche education for about 20 plus years now. I took my first class from you in the late 90s, I think.
Eastvale,
yeah.
That's right.
Yeah, I had a friend that got caught in one, and I woke up that day and I said, it's time to get educated.
So. Okay. So yes, exploring terrain. Okay, and you do a great job of finding the powder. And I agree with you. I don't share my locations because social media, people flock to those areas and be a big problem.
Yeah, exactly.
And I kind of believe the same way you do, is earn, you know, because as you're exploring, you're learning about avalanches. But if you just go right to the most dangerous spot, it's going to be trouble.
Yep, you know, and there's a lot of days in Colorado where it's high avalanche danger, right? Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of those places you can go to and still have a great time and stay out of that terrain. Whereas if you're not familiar with the area and you roll in there and you don't know what's above you, you can get caught just like that.
Exactly. Jeremy, do you use any apps when you're exploring terrain or checking it out?
Not really. I do a lot of my homework on the front end, Mike, and okay. I use Google Earth. So I'll spend, you know, an afternoon, morning researching a new zone I want to go to.
Okay.
And a lot of time I'll take screenshots mm-hmm. and what I'm looking for is what's above me. How can I get in there safely?
Sure.
And mainly just look at it from a safety standpoint. And then when I go into the zone, I have a general direction where I'm going, but I'm still exploring, having fun at the same time, if that makes sense.
So I use a couple of apps because I travel all over the country teaching classes. And I show up the night before and they're like, this is where you're going. And what I'll do is I'll pull up Google Earth.
Yeah.
And then I use another app called Fat Map, which gives me the slope angle. Okay. And so I get a rough idea of like, how steep is it? And I'll look at a topo map, I'll look at that, and then the best thing about Google Earth is you can see where the avalanche shoots up.
Yeah.
You know?
Yep.
And so I look at that, and then I'm looking at things like, okay, where is it narrower up? Where's the steeper terrain above me?
The cool thing about Google Earth too is you can turn it to 3D mode, and you can actually see the slope angle,
mm-hmm.
and then you can zoom in on areas and make sure there's like a good island of safety to get to, so you're
Excellent.
Not just rolling to the bottom of it going, uh-oh, I'm in trouble.
Right.
And so that's really helpful. That's why I really like that app a lot.
So with Gaia, I'm gonna show you how to plot a route. When looking at terrain, I'm looking at the steepness surrounding me and slide paths. Also careful about little terrain features, which can cause big problems. So this is the Gaia app. You know, if you're going to explore a new area, this is very helpful. You can do a route. And you're looking at the contour lines. You know, there's definitely steep terrain here. If it's low visibility conditions, you don't want to drop in there unexpectedly. Okay, we're gonna show you how to do our route on Gaia. Put this little icon here. Create route. Start. We just hold down. Following a route. So if we want to get to a certain area, you can spend time. Instead of trying to navigate on the fly, you have a predetermined route, and we do that and we just save it. And then if you're off, you don't have any cell service, you can download the map for this section. And when you're out there in the field, even without cell service, you'll know where you are on that route. I'm looking at areas of concern. Look at maps and apps to give you examples. Had to take a class through this valley last year for the first time. So here's what I did. I looked at Google Earth. Here's what I saw. Huge avalanche path. But are the avalanches running full path? How far are they running? Avalanche forecast helps with that information. Want to know how steep the slopes were above the trail? I use a topo map or an app for that. Some areas of concern. Need to communicate, spread out, only expose one person at a time, stay on the road, no cutting up onto the steep slope. Radios really make it easy to communicate. Analyze as we go, also looking at decision points. A decision point is a location where the group decides to proceed or not, depending on avalanche conditions, terrain, and other factors that would jeopardize safety. Some days you wouldn't even think of being here. On this day, it wasn't a problem. So Jeremy, here's a quick question for you. How often when you go out do the avalanche conditions change as you travel around?
Pretty often, actually. The snowpack can vary from one drainage to the next, especially if you change aspects and elevation, it can change almost all the time.
Do you think the forecasts are always accurate?
I think the general message is out there, but I wouldn't stick to it. You definitely need to do your own homework.
Sure, that's the way I look at it, is it's the starting point. I look at the forecast, and with some forecasts, you know, it's like, well, there's a persistent weak layer, the danger's higher. It's like that right away eliminates areas for me. It's like, we're not going for these climbs. We're gonna stick to these areas, but when we're going into those areas, you know, those forecasts, and Colorado's huge.
Yeah.
And they're taken from an area, and it's like, well, when we go out there, this is our starting point, but we have to be observing when we go up. Jeremy, you have turbo sleds here.
Do you hit
the climbs, big climbs every week?
Mike, every day, all day. First thing I do when I go out. Absolutely not. Honestly, a lot of the big climbs happen in the springtime here in Colorado when the snowpack goes through a freeze-thaw cycle and I feel really good about it and it's like bolted to the mountain. During the middle of the season, there's definitely days we can do some of the bigger climbs, but it takes just the right snowpack. It needs to be really, really dense down low and nice and fluffy up top.
Jeremy, do you ever leave the house thinking, oh, this is just going to be an average day, we got about this much snow, and then you get up there and there's a lot more snow. Does that ever happen to you?
It used to all the time, back before I did all my pre-homework of checking snow towels and things like that, but not so much anymore. I'll be slightly surprised, like maybe we'll get some winds from out of the northwest and it'll dump way more snow.
Sure.
On the leeward side, but for the most part, not so much anymore.
Okay. So how often, when you go into terrain, do you get surprised? Like you're cutting through the trees and then, you know, where I think we get in a lot of trouble is when we're exploring. I'm cutting through the trees, I get to an opening, and the first thing I do is I look uphill and it's like, this is not a good place to be. I either need to do a 180 and get out of here or get across it right away.
It's one of the hardest parts because it can happen so quickly. You all of a sudden poke out of the trees and you're like, crap, I'm in trouble, I shouldn't be here. And what's worse is your buddy behind you is with you and he's maybe gonna go beyond you, and that always scares me. So one of the really big things we do when we're exploring new terrain is always, always, always looking what is above you. Okay, so when I go into an area and I know the trees are pretty safe and tight, I'll even talk to my crew and say, hey, we're not going past this point because A, the snowpack's not stable today. We don't know what's going on up there. And if we can find a way to get in there safely and park, evaluate the snowpack from there, that's what we usually do.
And we use radios. So if I'm leading and I get out there, I'll slam on the brakes as I enter. It's like, hold up, guys. I gotta get out of here. I gotta get across it. Let me get across. And then you guys go one by one.
For sure. And the radios are probably the biggest game changer in the last few years, right? Or maybe 5 years.
But definitely,
they make such a difference being able to relay that information to the people you're riding with. Just being like, hey, do not, you know, even if you're not with them and you see them somewhere.
Sure.
Because maybe they don't know what's above them. You can get on that radio and let them know. It's an awesome tool.
Thanks for watching. Next week, we'll be covering more information. Get your riding partners to watch. You want to know this. Here's some links to win prizes and learn more.